So hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel CrackGate Online. So today in this video I am going to discuss two important numerical problems related with contour bond. So if you will be able to understand these two numerical problems, then it will be much more clear. You will get some command on this topic. So before going into the numerical problem, I will show you some more concept and some diagrams, so that you will get better understanding related with this topic. So let's begin. So here, as you can see, this what figure I have given here, I have shown you the diagram for one single contour bond. Okay, so for single bond, so this is the land slope. Okay, this S is the land slope. So land slope is in this direction, so your contour is in perpendicular to the plane. So here this is the impounding water depth. So here water is impounding. Okay, so here you will need to store the amount of water. And from theoretical point, how you can calculate that how much amount of water you need to store? So the water which is coming from the rainfall, that much amount of water only you can store. So that is equal to amount of rainfall into horizontal interval into 1, because we always calculate this for the unit length of the bond. If bond length is given, then you can calculate what is the volume. It will give you the volume. So basically here we are calculating the what is the area. Here it is given storage area required for the water, so it will be equal to RE into HI. So this is the amount of water which you need to store behind the bond. So for storing this much amount of water, what should be or what will be your bond cross section, this bond cross section that you have to calculate, and that becomes your numerical problem. Okay, so here I have given one bond. So what is this area, absorption area? So that area will become equal to this triangle plus, see, this triangle here, two triangles are there. And what is this? This is the depth of water, depth of impounding water, that we have calculated H equal to under root 2 RE into VI, that is same depth. So here I am denoting is at D. And what is the side slope of this trapezoidal? Side slope will be given in the question, that side slope will be horizontal raised to vertical. So here if it is given horizontal raised to vertical, then this is the horizontal, whether it is 1 or 2, and this will be the vertical distance. So how you can calculate this distance? So this distance you can calculate using the land slope, not the side slope. So if land slope is S, then here what you can write, S by 100 equal to this perpendicular, that is nothing but D, divided by this horizontal distance that you need to calculate, that is suppose it is X. So X will become equal to 100 D by S. So you please remember this thing, X is 100 D by S. Suppose S is 10%, that it will become 10 D. If it is S is 5, then it will become 20 D. So like you now you know this distance as well. So what is the area where you need to store the water? So here it is theoretical, and now you need to calculate the area. So it is half base into height. So this is the base that you have calculated, 10 D by S into height. Height is nothing but D, plus again for this triangle, that is again half base into height. So base, you know this base, that you can, how you know this base, that is based on the side slope of this. Suppose side slope is 1.5 raised to 1, then that will become horizontal, means 1.5 D. Okay, so 1.5 D into height again D. So that you need to equate with RE into HI, and from here you can calculate the value of D. That will become depth of impounding water. So I hope you got how to calculate the depth of impounding water based on the given rainfall data. Okay, so suppose if you are not taking this, you can simplify this diagram through here. So here it is bund, we are not giving this slope, but rather if you will draw a single line, then it will become straight. And if I am drawing this line as a straight line, so here it is showing as this straight line, and this seepage line, that seepage line has to pass through this point, so this will become like this. So this is the seepage. Suppose seepage line is given as 5:1, means 5 horizontal, so that will become 5d and ratio 1, so that is d again. Okay, so from 5d you can calculate, you have calculated the amount value of d here, so multiply into 5, so you know this width. And what is this? This is again from this side slope. Suppose it is 1.5:1, then it is 1.5d. now you know the entire base width. So you calculated the depth. It is depth of impounding water. How you will calculate the total depth? You need to add the freeboard, that is 25% of the d value. That will become the total height. And if you know the total height, this, so you subtract that total height, 5d minus 2 times 1.5 into that total height. So that these two portions you need to remove. Then you know the top width, you know the base width, you know the total height. Now you can calculate the cross section area. Let's quickly see one numerical problem. Okay, so till now I am assuming you know the, you understood this diagram. Okay, so from this diagram, what it is given, it is land slope is given, that is 2. So what I told, what will be this, so for 2%, I told what will be this, if s equal to 2, then that is 50d. Okay, so what will be the area, first area, half 50d. Okay, so that is, here it is 50 into d, and that d is given. So what is the horizontal slope? Horizontal slope is given, that side slope 1.5:1, so it became 1.5 into d. Okay, that d is given. What is the seepage line slope? That seepage line slope is given 5:1, so what it became, it became 5d, and it is again side slope 1.5d, it is given. So this depth is d only. So you know this area, half base into height, base is 50d, height is d. You know this area, half base is 1.5d, height is d. So how, so you need to equate this equal to how much is the horizontal interval, 100, into what is the rainfall, rainfall is 10 cm, minus, why minus, because 30% rainfall is abstracted, so that is already absorbed into the ground, so you don't need to store that amount. Okay, so effectively you need to store -3, you convert into meter. So always care about the unit. So if you will calculate here, so only unknown parameter is d. So you came to know about the depth of impounding water. So how you will calculate the total depth? Total depth here it is given as 20%. Okay, standard we take 25%, but in question itself it has mentioned 20%. So we need to multiply it 1.2 into d. So you will get the h, that is the total height. Now you know the d, so you know the total height, you know the base width, you know the top width, so you can calculate, you can calculate the cross section area. That was the question. Okay, so I hope this is the very typical question. Many people do not understand such type of question. So now you know what is the use of seepage line, what is the use of side slope, how you will calculate the cross section area, and what is the use of rainfall. This I calculated from here. So that storage area, you need to equate that storage area with the storage area behind the bund, because that is the area where you are going to store all your rainfall. So you calculate the storage requirement from the rainfall, and you equate that storage requirement behind the bund. using the dimension of D. That is nothing but the height of water impounding behind the bund. For this, you need to take the land slope as well as the side slope of the bund. Okay. So, I am giving you one question for the practice. This is the same question. So, I am giving you this question for the practice. Okay. So, here if you will read this question, let's quickly read and I am giving you the hint. So, here land slope is given. Okay. So, you can calculate this dimension. It is 4%, means 100 by 4 into D. It came as 25 D. Okay, so half base into height. Now you can calculate. Do you have the side seepage line slope? Okay, seepage line slope is given. So you know the seepage line slope as 4:1. So it become 4 D, and this is D itself. Okay, so for this you need to know the side slope. Is side slope is given? No, side slope is not given. But it has given that it is medium deep soil. Deep soil means it is clay soil. So for clay soil, what is the land slope? 1:1. So it again became the D. If it is the sandy soil, for sandy soil it is 2:1. So what will be the value of that base? It would have become 2D. For loamy soil, it would have become 1.5D. So now you know this is also D then. Okay. So what is the unknown parameter? You need to calculate the you need to calculate this area, half base into height, that half D into D, and you need to know this area, that is again half base into height. So base is 100 D. Okay, 100 D by 4 means 25 D. So 25 D into D. So you need to add these two area and equate into storage area, that is rainfall into horizontal interval. So horizontal interval is given as 50, or rainfall is given as infiltration is 20% and rainfall is 20 cm. So 20 cm, 4 cm is absorbed. So you effectively you got the 16 cm. So divided by 100. So that will be in meter square. So you equate this and calculate the height of D. So here in this question, free board is not given. So you can assume that free board as 25%, and from there you will come to know as the total height of the bund. From total height, you can calculate the base height. So here base height is 4D minus, I am telling you it is D, 2D. Okay, it is not 2D, it is 2H, because you have to calculate like this here. Okay, so at that will, so this D will become here H. So if it is 1.5D, then it will become 1.5H. okay, so from here you will calculate the top width. So you know top width, you know the base width, you know the total height. So you constructed the bund cross section. Suppose it is asking length of bund per hectare, then 10 to the power 4 divided by HI. So HI is what? It is given as 50. So all the parameter is given, you can calculate here. So these are the two very important numericals that completes your bunding topic. Bund is a very important topic. So I hope I have given the sufficient numerical problems, and even if you have any doubt, then please do comment. In the next video I will bring with graded bund, and from there we will complete this topic. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Thank you.